Śmrek!
This ain't a dream. This is reality, homie.
I'll show you better than I can tell you. Best believe that.
Let's go. Let's go.
The ink is dry. It's going to fuck down.
Summer Madness 2. Return of the Legends.
Welcome to URL's Battle Rap Arena with Street Star Noise, Hip Hop Psycho, and Jesse Regan. What's good?
Yep. Yeah, I'm good, man. You know, chilling. You know, had an amazing weekend. You know.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, I heard it was a lot of activity going on this weekend.
Yeah, you know, I went to the sparring session this weekend. Shout out to the Queen of the Ring. You know, had a sparring session. Then, you know, they had the, the next day they had the Queen of the Ring battle. We had a little bit of everything, man. We had, some good battles, some good fights. Yeah, but you know how it goes, man. Yeah, we have good shit happening, so.
Mm-hmm.
Life is good. Jesse, how was your weekend, man? Did you visit the Retard Clinic this weekend?
I actually just worked this weekend, but I do want to say a rest in peace to the family members of the Colorado tragedy.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. My heart's there. Like, I can't believe what happened. I'm at gasp for words with that.
No, I feel you. Yeah, rest in peace to all the people that passed away, and a prayers go out to everybody's family. You know what's crazy? I wouldn't even think about that. My head was so far out there, but we definitely got to send a shout out to all of them.
Mm-hmm.
I got to see how people can just do stuff like that. I actually did see Batman, though. It was a dope movie,
mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah, I seen that. I seen Ted. Ted is hilarious. I want Ted, like, to be my best friend. Like, that's my nigga right there, Ted. Like, if I can find Ted before Summer Madness, I'm bringing him to Summer Madness, and he's going to help host the battles, because that's my nigga right there. Ted is my nigga. You know, he's got, imagine having a best friend like Ted, man. You know what I mean? Like, that's my nigga. But the other thing, I don't do drugs, but I would do drugs with my nigga Ted because he's fucking hilarious. You know what I mean? Like, it was amazing to be watching that movie, man. Like, when the nigga did the coke, I was thinking to myself, I would have did the coke with the nigga. Fuck it.
You know,
it was crazy, man. Like, shout out to my nigga Ted. That's my dude. You know what I mean? You know, I don't know.
You got me wanting to see that movie now.
Yeah. I mean, it was a great movie. It was a great movie. If you definitely want to see it, Batman was dope too. You know what I mean? There's a lot of things. Like I said, I was at the Queen of the Ring battle, the Old Red versus Miss Hustle. You know, shout out to Old Red.
How'd that go down?
Shout out to Old Red. He's the Queen of the Ring, so that's dope. You know what I mean? They gave him, like, a little crown afterwards. It was dope. Like, after the battle, you know, they had some judges. It was crazy. And, they picked Old Red to battle. I'm going to win. And they gave him. It was dope. It was a nice ceremony. Like, Bab started, even Bab started to cry. They gave him a crown. Old Red was really emotional. I mean, it was great. I felt like he won the Miss America pageant, to be
honest. Oh, man. Did they give him a book too, son?
They gave him flowers. A little hash with his name on it, new Queen of the Ring. So any of you girls out there that want to see the new Queen of the Ring, you got to go see Orette, because he's the new Queen of the Ring. He's dominating it. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Shout out to Miss Hustle. She's dope. But, it happens. You know what I mean?
Well, we got to do with us that's after the crown on the URL stage. We got Mr. Dean Amos to get him. I'll let him introduce himself. Go ahead, D.
Yo, man, it's DNA, man. Y'all know the rest, man. What's up?
Get the fuck out of here, Jesse. That was the worst intro I've ever seen in my life. That was horrible.
How would you have done it any better?
What I'm asking Nobs, man. Nobs know what everything else is. I don't got to say it no more, man. I'm chilling. Oh,
it's Mr. Get him the fuck out of here. It's my nigga DNA. I mean, you're AT. Let me ask you a question. Would you be interested in going after that Queen of the Ring title? Because, now all that holds it. I mean, is this something you're interested in doing?
Fucked up, man.
Nah, man, that's not something that's, on my mind right now. I'm not worried about that. I hear they got a new champion out there. No, salute to him.
He got really emotional when they handed him the flowers. Like, that was a beautiful scene. Like, I hope they released the footage. Like, he teared, and I was like, wow. Like, he gave a little speech,
on a serious note, though, I commend him for doing that. A lot of male battlers wouldn't even try to test those waters and battle a female. So, from what I heard he did a good job, So, it worked out in his favor.
He's in the ring, so you got to shout out Robert. That's my nigga right there, man. I'm just joking around right now for everybody. Don't take it serious, but, they did give him a hashtag and flowers and a crown. But it was actually a really good night, too. I mean, I'm surprised DNA wasn't there, which he's at every battle of it. What happened, D? What the hell were you?
Nah, man. I had some other things to take care of, man. I wish I could have been there. I heard it was crazy. Shout out to Debo and, Babs and Vegas for doing Queen of the Ring.
It was definitely an amazing event. I had a lot of fun, man. I seen a lot of, it's crazy. Actually, I walked down a couple blocks, too, and there was an incident, too, like a couple blocks away. Had nothing to do with Queen of the Ring. I seen somebody get maced and literally drink the mace. Like, it was crazy. Like, the mace could not bring the individual down. Like, she drank the mace and continued to move forward. Like, she became the Incredible Hulk. It was amazing. So I had a very interesting weekend. Interesting weekend, you know what I mean? Like I said, I shout out to my nigga Ted, that's my dude, but we're here to talk about my nigga DNA, who's battling the Cheesecake Man himself, E-Max.
Yes, sir, man, someone about this too, Webster Hall, DNA versus E-Max, sir.
I'm gonna let, Jesse Weekend, this is his interview, and my nigga Psycho. I'm going to fall back, and I'm going to let you guys get this shit popping. What's up?
Well, D, correct me if I'm wrong, this is something that you've been working your battle rap career for. There's a lot of established artists that were not able to make that Summer Madness 2 stage, yet you were able to make it. How do you feel about that in general?
I wouldn't say this is something I work for because, when I started battling, I didn't know this was going to come about. But this is something that I definitely wouldn't want to miss out on. So, it's a blessing. I'm fortunate to be on there, It's a lot of other dudes that's talented that could have deserved to be there. But, URL, they called me with the call, and, I'm on there with E-Nuts. So, this is my second Summer Madness, so, Fortunately, I've been able to be on both. Well, I will be on both after the 19th, but, I have a match on both, so we're going to see what happens.
Right, okay. And, you could choose to answer, you could choose not to answer, but, can we expect cheesecake jokes?
You know what I like to say to people doing that, what people don't understand what they're doing is that in a way y'all hurting the battle and y'all helping the battle. You know, I see a lot of people tweeting, I see the forums commenting, oh, D Nation talk about Cheesecake, D Nation talk about P. Diddy or Bad Boy, and when I see that, all I say is that, why don't people just don't say nothing and see if I do it? If I do it, then after the battle, comment and say, DNA was an idiot, he shouldn't have did that. That was predictable, that was expected. But don't ruin it before the battle. And what I mean by ruining is that if I did have that in my rhyme, y'all telling me what not to do. So y'all not helping Enes, y'all hurting them. If y'all are Enes fans, whoever's doing it, because you letting me know what y'all don't want to hear. So if I had it in there, I'm going to scratch it out. And now, y'all just help me be even better. And if I don't have it in there, then y'all just bringing out, y'all just saying angles. Like, I never like when people do that. Like, if y'all watch before any battle when I didn't have a tooth, I never told nobody, oh, I hope you don't come with tooth jokes. Let him do what he's going to do. Because if he does it, he's going to fail. You feel me? I'm not going to announce what somebody shouldn't do. Do what you feel like doing. That's why that's why people should comment after the battle. If I do it, that was silly. And what I also want to just announce, I could be wrong, but I doubt Enes is going to go 3 rounds without saying anything about my tooth. So I hope the same rules apply to him when he says anything about it, like anything. You know, because the same way people go, oh, the Cheesecake jokes is old, Enes only had 2 battles mentioning it. I have over 21 battles, and in all 21 of them, with a tooth or without one, someone mentions it. I get a tooth, and they still mention it. You know what I mean? So I don't pay attention to that because people excuse what they want to excuse and allow what they want. You can sit there and allow a dude to still talk about my tooth, and I have one. I have it. So anytime he says something, if that's the rule y'all want to use, he should get booed or you shouldn't even consider the line, no matter if it's hot or not. Like, don't mention it. The whole point of me getting one was for people to stop. You know what I mean? So with all that being said, it's just like people just talk the talk, man. If something's hot, you're going to like it. And I mean, people said they was tired of tooth jokes until Young Ill put out Dental Floss, and it was creative, so you liked it. Or tooth jokes was whack until X Factor said it about priorities, then y'all liked it again. So y'all don't know, y'all can't say what you don't want to hear because you don't know how I'm going to put it. So if I do mention Cheesecake and it's put in the best way you ever heard, you're going to like it. And if I don't mention it, then I'm just not going to mention it. But y'all don't got to wait for August 19th to find out all that. I'm not going to tell y'all. I mean, that's the fun part about it.
All
right. You're definitely right, but I mean, one of the fun parts of being a fan is to speculate on what somebody's going to talk about, you know?
What I'm saying is speculate, but don't vocally say it. Like if somebody's an Enes fan, right? Y'all think by writing on Twitter or writing me on Facebook or writing anywhere where it's visible for me to see, oh, DNA better not come up with Cheesecake jokes, is helping Enes, it's hurting him. Because if I had that in my rhyme, now you're showing me what not to do. So you get what I'm saying? Like, if you're an Enes fan, you better off just speculating and not saying nothing. Because you're not helping them. You're hurting them. Because once you let me know what you think I'm going to say, then I'm going to revert it and not say it. Or I'm going to do something else with it. You're giving me the heads up before we battle. You know what I mean? It's almost like the fans is telling the battle before it happens. So that's what I'm trying to say. Like, if you're a DNA fan and you just don't want to hear me say it, then I mean, fine. But I see a lot of Enes fans saying, DNA don't talk about that, but, like, y'all helping me. Or it's corny if DNA does that. But, like, you can never say nothing like that, man. And just for people to know, you know, when I battled X Factor last year on Summer Madness 1, y'all tell me where y'all heard those jokes.
Nah.
What happened?
I'm just saying the dude I battled, there was a predictable angle that I didn't use. Just stating, I'm saying like my tooth is just as famous as Enes with the Cheesecake. So I mean, to me, it's all the same thing. All I'm saying is that. This is all I'm saying. I'm not going to tell y'all if I'm going to mention it or not. All I'm saying is that everybody that doesn't want me to say the Cheesecake jokes, I hope y'all heard Enes round and he has nothing in there about my tooth. Because if he does, I'm writing everybody. As soon as I hear him mention it, I'm jumping for joy. Because you can't tell me, come on, man. Nobody, you know what's so crazy? I've never battled nobody that hasn't mentioned my tooth. Never. Ever. At least one line. They said something about it. So I doubt if he's going to be the first one not to do it. We'll see.
I, you know what, I think he might actually be, because a thing with Ness, too, is Ness is, like, we just had that conversation the other day, Ness doesn't really hit you with an angle of, like, a tooth or something, but he'll just spit straight bars at you.
Yeah, I mean, so, what I'm saying is that I battle people that spit bars, but how do I put it? That's like battling Jay-Z and you don't mention Beyonce. Like, whether you spit regular bars, whether you get personal or not, you're going to say something about it at least one time. That's what you know him. That's what's associated with him. And, like, it's almost like it hasn't been one battle where somebody hasn't mentioned Charlie Clips. That's my man. Mm-hmm. Vice versa. When Clips battles, they mention me. You feel me? So it's like, man, I don't care about that. Like, that's why I don't play the prediction game, because you're going to see something that's expected if that's what somebody's associated about. It's not what you say. The saying is how you say it. That's bottom line. You got niggas that rap nowadays that's mainstream niggas, or you got us that's battle niggas. Sometimes I don't say the hottest shit, but it's the way I say it that'll make you like it. So it's not about what I'm saying, it's how I'm saying it. So that's all it boils down to. What way you put it, you know what I mean? Because, like, after a while, I got tired of niggas mentioning my tooth, but when Young Nils did the dental floss and X Factor did the priorities, it's like how they put it, I respected it. I thought it was hot, because they didn't just, it was the way they did it. So, you know, we going to see, though, man. That's all I'm saying, man. Like, the playing field is even, you know what I mean? It's one strike against both of us, the tooth and the cheesecake. So, we going to see what Enes do, you know what I mean? I know what I'm going to do, but we going to see what I do.
I mean, you just said the battle of King of the Dot versus Earth. And, I mean, correct me or wrong, that was like a week and a half preparation, right? But
yes,
you guys might have had, like, the battle of the night that night. You know, like, damn, this was such a flop. Arsenal versus Immaculate didn't live up to, like, what people were expecting. But, like, people liked your battle. And a lot of people gave you the win. The majority of the people gave you the win for that night. I mean, do you think, like, you may have the same effect as Summer Madness? I mean, are you looking to have, like, the battle of the night? Is that one of your priorities?
Like my goal, man, anytime I get in the ring, I mean, is to have the best performance. You know what I mean? I can't say the best battle, because that's up to Enes. You know what I mean? He got to come with it. I hope he comes with it. If he comes with it, then yeah, you know, a lot of people get confused. A good battle takes two people, not one. So if Enes was to do his thing and I didn't do my thing, it wouldn't be a good battle, or vice versa. If I do my thing and he don't do his, it's not going to be good. You know what I mean? Why me and Ur was the best battle tonight is because I came with it and Ur came with it. And you know what I mean? A lot of people just think I came with it a little more, but we both came with it. Some people think he won. But you know what I mean? My goal is for me to have the best performance. You know what I mean? So that's what I'm going in there thinking. Now, if Enes has 1-2, then we'll have the battle tonight. But I can only worry about myself.
Yeah, well, how do you answer to your critics? Because, like, I've been hearing a lot of talk since the Summer Madness 2 card came out that, like, a lot of people felt like you was the one person that probably didn't belong on the card. Like, what do you have to say about all that? Like,
I mean, what I got to say is that, you know what I mean? Why wouldn't I? That's the act. Like, see, people get stuff confused. It's one thing not to like DNA. I don't mind if you don't like me. The world is made for people not to like certain people. You don't got to like the way I rap. You don't got to like me as a human being. But respect has to be given when a dude's put in work. You know what I mean? Like, who's to say I shouldn't be on the card? I've been battled in every league. I've been the main event in every league. When it comes to the views, I get the views. When it comes to the followers, I get the followers. I've been battled the biggest names in battle rap. I've been battled in front of the biggest names in the industry. So, how can you say I don't belong on the card?
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? You can say you don't want me on the card. You didn't prefer DNA on the card, but to say I don't deserve to be on it, that's crazy. Because at 21, I accomplished more than these niggas that's 30. More than these niggas that's 25. More than these niggas that's 21. I accomplished more than niggas that's my age. So when people say that, you just gotta laugh. Like, they're not thinking. Like, no one on the card, I don't think, doesn't deserve to be on the card. Everybody in their own rightfully way put in the work to deserve to be on it. Now, this is where people get confused. It's not that we don't deserve to be on there, but do other people deserve to be on there? Yeah. I mean, I don't got any control over that. I mean, there's plenty of niggas that's from URL that battle that I would personally put on the card. If the card
who would you put on the card? Who do you feel is missing from that card, if anybody?
I feel X Factor should be on the card. I think from 2011 to 2012, X Factor put in his work. You know what I mean? He had a good showing against Surf, a good showing against me, a good showing against Rich. You know what I mean? Before Big T battled, you know what I mean? A lot of people were saying he did the best against Clips, you know, even though I feel like Clips won. And then, you know I mean, he just did numbers against Verb. So, right to quick, I will put X Factor on the card. You know, I mean, going off of last year, I will put Tech on the card. You know, Tech had one of the best performances last year.
I feel like Tech
should be on the card. You know, I heard Young Hill was going through some situations. You know what I mean? I ain't going to speak on that. You know what I mean? I hope he's good or whatever. But if he was straight, I feel like he should be on the card. Big T could be on the card. It's dudes out there that, you know what I mean? Me personally, if the card was extended or, you know what I mean, they make it, you know what I mean? I don't know, more battles, then yeah, they could be on it. Or if they swap with us, whatever. But those dudes, I feel like, you know what I mean, they deserve it just as well as anybody else that's on it.
No, B, I got a quick question. I do mean to interject. to touch on the subject of people saying you don't deserve it, which I totally disagree, to be honest with you. I think you're one of the top dudes. When people say elite and you don't mention DNA, I think it sounds ridiculous. Now, having said that, why do you feel as if people look past you?
Meaning battle rappers,
like,
or...?
Yeah, like a lot of times when people mention elite, and a lot of times they kind of try to downplay or they're trying to avoid you in the battle, you feel like it's because of your age. What is it exactly that people are more willing to shoot for Charlie Clips as opposed to a DNA?
I'm gonna tell you why, because I'm a dude that don't care. You see, like all right, check it out, right? This is what I'm gonna say. Like Clips, right? If you battle Clips, because of what he created in the battle world, and you know what I mean, he arguably still hasn't lost the round, and still arguably hasn't lost the battle. It's like I'm gonna aim for Clips, because even if I come up some way short, I'm still get props because I did halfway good and nobody else has. Everybody else got destroyed or everybody else lost. So if I come this close, then wow. Or God forbid if I beat him, it's you know what I mean, I'm through the roof. It's like with Mook, you know what I mean, everybody want to battle Mook. Because it's like, okay, you know, everybody says he's the greatest, so if somehow I beat him, I'm there. But if you battle DNA and you lose, everybody's going to say you lost to a 21-year-old. So it looks better. See, that's what people don't understand. It's not about lyrics anymore with anything, with battling, with the industry, or nothing. It's all about image. It's how it looks. No grown man, you know what I mean? And I'm a grown man now because I'm 21, but no grown man that's older than me, that's 25, 27, 30, they don't want to lose to me. They got kids that's somewhere in my age bracket, from 14 to somewhere down, that in school, the kids that, oh, you lost the DNA. DNA's only like 5 years older than us. Nobody wants to hear that. And I've seen it, because there's no other reason why. When you talk about in terms of popularity, I got it. When you talk about the name, I got it. When you talk about the cosigns, I got it. It's no reason why. And I'm not going to say I'm the best nigga out. You know what I mean? I'm not going to say that, but I'm talented. So there's no reason why battling DNA wouldn't make sense, except if you don't want to lose. And then on top of that, I don't care about losing. I don't care about that. That's why I'm doing it. That's why I'm doing it. You know what I mean? Out of everybody that's top tier, I'm probably the only dude that's been battled almost. I don't care who it is, because I'm here to test my ability. I'm not here for image. I'm not here for a show. I'm not here to say what it looks good. You know what I mean? Oh, that looks good because I'm battling this nigga. Or it looks good for me to tell this nigga. No, if it makes sense and the money is right, I'm there. Because I'm going to find out if you think that nigga's that nigga, I'm going to find out if I'm that nigga if I beat him. So.
Now, DNA, recently, we spoke on the last week. Ness was supposed to call in, but Jesse and him, I don't know what happened. And I bring up a point where people were like, a lot of people saying Ness is going to get chilled. And I've seen that a lot. And I bring up the point where I was like, Ness has done better on Smack style battles when it came to basically street and just rapping. And you guys are similar in the fact that you guys really don't focus on angles, you focus on rapping. Now, having said that, you have fared well outside of URL more than here, when you battle disaster, you got a lot more love, and so on and so on. And your best performance probably on Smack was when you beat when you battled Sir. Now, why do you think you perform better outside of UL as opposed to here? And is it a difference with the streak aspect of it as opposed to battling outside of the league?
To be real, I just think in the other battles I was more comfortable. You know what I mean? Me coming to URL and then a lot of dudes, you know what I mean? Like, I see everything. I hear everything. I watch everything. I'm not gonna say, I'm not one of them dudes to say, oh, I don't pay attention. I pay attention. So a lot of dudes, oh, DNA is not believable. DNA this, DNA that on the URL side of things. So, you know what I mean? Yeah, beyond those people being ignorant and not understanding this entertainment, and like 95% of these niggas that say they do what they do don't do it. So, whatever, besides all that, I started letting it get in my head, like, oh, now I got something to prove. And I feel like when I go outside of URL, I don't feel that way, because there's nothing to prove. Over there, to me, it's just like rapping. All right, either I'm good or he's good. Now, you know, either he's good and I'm better. But I feel like, even though a lot of people say the Tech battle was whack, I feel like in that battle, I was comfortable. I didn't care. You feel me? And when I've come to Summer Madness 2, it's like ever since the disaster battle, and I guess because that battle meant something, because of the rivalry, because of the history, wherever it went down at, it just changed battle rap the way I battle rap. And what I mean by that is my comfortability level. It's nothing a nigga can do at all anymore to get me off my A game, to get me off anything. If you look at my last three disaster Earl Tech, that's the most comfortable I ever looked on camera ever, because I don't care anymore. It's like, what else do I got to prove? I proved I can battle the best niggas. I proved I can battle in front of some of the legends in the game and some of the new dudes in the mainstream level. I done proved that I can be creative with my rhymes. I proved that I can go to a different country or I can go to a different state and still get loved. So it's like...
But still, to be fair, too, like, and I think you would even admit this, you versus this is DNA of his A game. You versus her is DNA of his A game. You versus Tech is you at your B game beating Tech at a C game. Oh, you disagree.
But what I'm trying to say is that whether I'm on my A, like, first of all, being on your A game, your B game, whatever game you're on, you got to be comfortable. Like, somebody can be on their A game with lyrics and be on their B game with confidence, and that's going to make them have a C performance. You get what I'm saying? So maybe against Tech, I didn't say the hottest stuff that I said against Earl Disaster, but the comfortability level was on 8+. That's why a lot of people felt like I beat him, because that's the whole thing with Tech. Nobody's confident when they battle him. That's why everybody thinks they lose. It's just that's what comes with performance, the image, the demeanor, that he's going to break you down and make you feel like you ain't shit when you battle him. So the whole point is that nobody's ever seen anybody stand up to Tech. Nobody's ever seen the battle be like, oh, I don't know. Wow, it's even. It's always Tech comes in, he does the SPI shit, the other nigga spits his rhymes, and the crowd stops fucking with him. So in that battle, that didn't happen. So that's what I'm trying to say. Now, we want to talk about in terms of lyrics. Yeah, I spit better lyrics in a lot of other battles than that one. If you talk about confidence, I'm confident. On the URL stage, that's probably the most confident I look since Surf.
Now, DNA, due to the fact that...
How confident are you? Can we expect you to look on Summer Madness too? Yeah, go ahead.
Due to the fact that in everybody's eyes, and this is the majority of people's eyes, DMF is an enormous underdog. Do you think that plays in the favor of DMF, where people are expecting so much less from him and so much more from you, that I could actually sway people's opinions on the battle if he does well?
I mean, in this particular instance, I have to say it's the first time that I actually might not be the underdog in a battle. But to me, it's still a decent amount of people that think Enes is going to win. So I feel like if he shows up, it's not going to be, I don't know, man. Honestly, I don't think it's in nobody's favor in this one. But,
If he does good, it's going to be in his favor. I'm thinking about it. It would, because so many people, I mean, this is not what I think, so I don't want nobody to quote this and be like, oh, DNA.
I think he's going to do good, and I'm not even saying it just to say it. I really do, because I think the stage is set. I really do, because I think the stage is set. I mean, his back is against the wall, he's going to show up. But a lot of people don't think so. So, yeah, I have to say this one, a lot of people is going for me. So it's insane if he does, if he wins the round. It's like, I mean, we can show that a lot of people saying 3-0.
All right. Yo, y'all want to go to some fans? See what they got to say?
Let's hear the question from the fans. What's up?
You said something, Norris? All right, go, fans. 917, you there?
Yeah, y'all hear me?
Yeah, we hear.
Hello? Yeah, what's up, Nell? What's up, DNA?
Yo, what's up?
Chilling, man. Yo, listen, man. I want to know what you think about the other battles besides yours. And, you know, your predictions for those battles in the Summer Madness 2 card.
Honestly, I mean, first off, I think all the battles is, I mean, good in their own way. They all got some type of history or they all got some type of excitement behind them. Yeah, I mean, besides me battling with A-Verb and T-Rex, you know what I mean, that's a tough one. I think they both going to show up, but if I had to pick a winner, I'm going to go with T-Rex. With Calico and Lux, lyrically, I think Loaded Lux is like 10 times better than Calico. But Calico's stage performance is crazy. He had one of the best performances last year at Summer Madness. But me being off the lyrics, I'm gonna go with Lux. But Calico, you know what I mean? He definitely got stage performance, and when he wants to, he be saying some shit. So I'm gonna go with Loaded Lux on that one. But it could go either way. But I'm gonna go with Lux. Clips and Sirius Jones can freestyle. Clips can freestyle. Clips could joke. Sirius Jones could joke. But
come on, dude, you don't have to break that one down. We know we're gonna have one more.
Yeah, but I'm being. But see, this is what I'm saying, though. I'm being honest, man. I'm not. But this is what people don't understand, man. Charlie Clifton told me I lost battles before. So I'm waiting for the day when he loses one for me to tell him. So when everybody thinks, oh, DNA is just with Clips because that's his man, nah. I want to give him. I want to give him back what he gave me. But on a serious note, though, honestly, I just think that Clips bars is harder.
I agree with you. Clips is like one of the best right now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Freestyle and joking wise, I think they even because Sirius Jones can freestyle real good and he can joke well. But bar for bar, Clips is better. That's why I'm going with Clips. You know what I mean? You got to go with the category that puts somebody over. Everywhere else, they're even. So with that note, I'm going with Clips. And finally, with Mook and Ian Solomon, I just feel like Murder Mook is going to do what he has to do, and I'm going with Mook. I just think that the stage is set at the perfect time for him to return, and he's going to do what he got to do.
No doubt. All right. I appreciate that. That's what it is, man. Yo, good luck on your battles. I will be there. I seen you at that last event, the Poison Pen joint. Out of ball, that shit was crazy. You know what I'm saying?
So, all right, good looking, yo. No doubt, man.
No doubt, man.
All right, good looking for calling, yo. I appreciate it.
No all doubt, right. Thanks for the call. Let's go to 732. You there?
Yo, what's up?
What's good?
New North, I got a question. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, North.
Yo, y'all gonna put Jesse in the bathroom like the mush for the battles?
I know, dumb question.
I should put him in the battle, in the bathroom. If he, you ever see the Bronx Tale? Put him in the bathroom. You know what I'm talking about? The DNA.
I think, yo, is Norris there?
What? Norris is crying.
Yo, Norris, you didn't hear?
I think they should put him in the bathroom, lock the door, and after the battles, let him out. Because I'm betting everything against you, Jesse. All right. Good luck, DNA. I just want to see you have a good performance. And shout out to all y'all doing a good job. All right? One.
All right.
Good looking, yo.
Yo, and people say that I call battles wrong, but I call money bags and heartless. Don't believe the myth. I don't call battles wrong.
Would you say, Jesse, you don't call the battles wrong?
I call money bags heartless, right?
Yeah, you know, we all know Jesse Jinx is alive, son. That shit is real. Speaking of which, DNA, you know everybody ain't pick you. You know that, right?
Come on.
You said what?
You know everybody pick you. You know that, right?
I couldn't hear you. It was breaking up again, my fool. Say it again.
Nah, I was saying, you know everybody didn't pick you. You know that, right?
Pick me with what?
For Summer Madness.
What you mean?
Yeah, we got somebody lying right here.
Jesse said that you're going to get washed 3-0.
I didn't say washed. See? Yo, DNA knows this anyway. DNA seen my Twitter anyway, so like to bring it up now is...
Yeah, I mean,
it seems like you're scared, Jesse. I mean, it's all right. You know? DNA's not going to beat you up. You should be happy to pick it. So you picked AMS because Jesse Jinx is real.
Yeah.
It really is. Like,
it is what it is, man. You know what I mean? Just reeking, I don't know what it is, man. I don't know if you got an obsession with Philly rappers or what, man. But, you know, hopefully I don't battle a Philly dude next time, man. Because every time I battle him, he picks him.
Well, you know what it is? Jesse actually dances in Philly. So...
It's all coming to light now, man. I think he was born there, man. But it's all good, man. I like people to be honest, you know what I mean? I don't want somebody to, just because I'm on the phone with you or we doing the interview or because you tweeting me or you see me in the street, you think I'm going to win. If you feel like I'm going to lose, tell me, you know what I mean? That's only going to make me go harder.
I wish I could give my opinion, man. I really wish. Okay, man, that was your question. I had an interesting conversation earlier on Twitter, right?
Mm.
It was really interesting. I know a lot of people seen it. And apparently, I have favors, and I'm a little upset that I put people on. Now, the crazy thing is, right? Did I bring you to the URL?
You said what?
Did I not bring you into the URL?
No, I brought myself, man.
No,
all joking aside, yeah, you set up the first battle I have with Wumpy on URL.
Okay, I got another question. Did I not bring Cortez into URL?
Yeah, you set Cortez up with X-Factor. I mean, if you want credit, no, I'll tell everybody, man. For the first three events, with everybody coming, like Hollow, Stokan, and I mean, not even that, just all the battles that got set up, Nobs was setting them up, like almost every battle that went down for like the first three events, and Nobs was putting the cards together. If anybody wants to know, I'm vouching, I've seen them.
And I'm not even talking about the cards, though. I'm talking about bringing people along, because apparently we had a retalk that just felt the way that I don't feel like he's a good rapper. And you know, you know I keep it real with him. If you're nice, you're nice, if you're not, you're not. And I put on probably 90%.
Yeah, so who is it that you're talking about, man?
It's not worth mentioning his name. He's not good. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
I just want to touch on it. Just let everybody know that, you know, whatever. But let's get back to the interview. I think we will answer questions from the fans.
All right. It's 3-7, you there?
Yo.
Yeah, what's good?
Hey, what up, y'all? What up, Norb, Jesse, Psycho?
What's up, bro?
What's good?
Hey, what up, DNA?
What's good?
Chilling. I was touching on what you was talking about as far as use the props when Young Ill pulled out the fucking... The dental floss, that was like the most corniest, terrible thing because, like, I'm not feeling the whole idea of pulling out a prop in a rap battle. You know, like,
yeah.
I don't know, she's making a mockery of this rap shit, like, and, like, that is, like, all time low, other than when, Head Ice was battling some guy and he had somebody come in for him, like, what the fuck is this turning into? Like, seriously, like, I'm not feeling this shit. But as far as you and your future battles, you say you want to battle the best. So do you see yourself in the ring one day with the likes of Lux or Murder Mook or Iron Solomon? We already, you already, I mean, ain't got to talk about the next thing. You already got that in the bag.
I mean, yeah, I mean, if they willing to do it, man, you know what I mean, hell yeah. I mean, I don't want to go into too many people's business, but to be honest, Lux, Sirius, and Mook, it was in the talks for me to battle all three of them at Summer Madness 2, but it didn't go down. So, I mean, if the situation arises again and they with it, then, yeah, I mean, you know what I mean? Well, first off, we got to see how Summer Madness 2. I ain't going to discredit none of them. They showed they were the best, but now at Summer Madness 2, they got to show they're still the best. So we all know after Summer Madness 2 who, I mean, because depending on how the battles go, man, the ranks is going to change a lot. That's the crazy part about it.
Yeah, you right.
But definitely, talent-wise, I feel like they are one of the best, so I will battle them.
All right. And for the record, yeah, your boy is going down, DNA. Sorry.
Who?
Glitz, he's done.
Yeah, man, I can't agree with that, man.
I'm saying I do. I agree with that. I'm out. Come on.
Nah, right, man. Okay, that's crazy, man. I'm not even going to say nothing, man. Y'all just see you on August 19th. For everybody that's saying that. That's crazy.
Let's go to 919. You there?
He was good.
Was good.
Oh, nice. I got a question for DNA. I ain't a big fan of DNA, but man, you got to stop back at my man K-Shine, man. Y'all got to get it in, my nigga.
That would be a good battle.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not ducking K-Shine. It's whenever you all want to shut it up. Well, I mean, I'm with it. That's one thing about me, man. It's whatever, man. That's what y'all want to see. I've seen people write for a long time. I'm just waiting. Whenever they get K-Shine on the line, I mean, I fuck with K-Shine. I'm cool with him and all that, but that's what y'all want to see. I mean, there ain't nothing like going at it, spitting lyrical and finding out who's the best. So I'm all for it. Never niggas make that call or trying to turn it up. We can get it.
Oh, yeah. All right. That's all I had to ask.
Right.
No doubt. You know,
we actually had O Solo on Thursday, and called out Sway Server. Sway Server,
you
call him Swerve.
What do you call him? You didn't call out Sway.
Swerve, my bad. Swerve Server.
It's another the same band got gifted, and Swerve is talented, and then God gifted. That's what he said. You want to quote it right.
Yeah. What do you think about that battle, yo, if they were to go down?
O Solo versus Swerve.
Yeah. I mean, I ain't see that many battles from O Solo, so I don't know.
He's Bob Clifford.
I'm battling with Swerve or Dino, so, I mean, I ain't really see, I don't even know if it'd be a good battle. No, I mean, no disrespect to O Solo, but I haven't seen a battle in, like,
nigga, what do you mean? You're about to what you
mean?
I'm
God tripping.
I was gonna go fight you. I'm gonna kill you,
then, right? What? Nigga, I was kill you, then, right? Yeah, man. With that voice, man, you're killing yourself. But so good.
Yeah, stupid. Go to 262. You there?
Yeah. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah, we are.
Yeah. How are you?
Yeah, what's up?
What's up, y'all? What's up, DNA? This twin.
How y'all doing?
All right. Yeah, I got a couple questions. My first question is, DNA, said in, I think, a couple of your blogs that in every battle that you've been in, you always been an underdog. Like, I guess you said that because you think, I guess you don't think you get the credit that you deserve sometimes, or people might be sleeping on you or whatever. So my question is, what do you think you got to do to wake people up, make them give you the credit that, you know, that you think that you deserve? Because it seems like a lot of people don't really put you maybe in the top tier, other people, you know, be in top tier. So what do you think you got to do to make people, you know, believe in you and put you in that top tier class?
I mean, at this point, man, it ain't nothing. I don't think it's nothing I can do, but it's nothing that I'm trying to do. You know what I mean? It's like, people, like, it's not even that I don't think people don't know I'm top tier, because it's like, whether you mention me on a positive level or a negativity level, you mention me, and you know who I am. I think it's more so people just try to fight it or they try to come up with some reason. Like, the funniest thing would be, yo, man, I'm going to be real, yo, DNA's ugly. And then I just be sitting there laughing like, first of all, y'all men. So if a girl says that, I'm going to excuse her. But y'all men. So first of all, why y'all judging the way I look? And second of all, what does my looks have to do with the way I run? Or DNA's dirty. And then that's when I still go back to the same thing. Like, what does that have to do with ramen? So when I be seeing people's excuses, half of the time it don't even be about what I'm saying. It's some whole other stuff. Or DNA doesn't have a tooth. Or his tooth is fake. So it's just like, I'm not worried about trying to please those people. Like, if you're here to listen to lyrics and you like my lyrics, then it is what it is. If you don't, then, you know what I mean? I mean, that's the way I rhyme. So, you know, I mean, everybody ain't going to like you. But in terms of battles, I just feel like because of my age and, you know what I mean, people just always try to count me out. But at this point, it ain't like nothing else that I'm trying to do or nothing I feel I need to do. If you still count me out at this point, then to me, there's something wrong with you. Now, I'm not saying you can't feel like the other person is going to win, but you can't count me out because it's been like 4 times in a row and about 8 times in my whole career, and almost like 7 out of those 8, or all 8 for 8, I rose to the occasion. Whether I won or lost, every time somebody counted me out, oh, you're going to get body bagged, or oh, you can't win, either I won or it's a debatable battle. So, I mean, it is what it is. And to this date, just off of my talent and I guess timing in battles, I still have never been killed in a battle. So I never understand where people get that this person is going to kill you. Like, I mean, so just people talking, man. That's why people got mouths, man, to talk.
All right, and my second question was, I think it was either today or yesterday, I see you going back and forth with Aquas earlier. Besides Aquas, is there anybody else that you are looking forward to battle after this Enough battle, after Summer Madness? And how come you and Aquas keep going back and forth? Like, how did that originate? Because y'all been going back and forth for
over a year.
Also, right?
That thing
I'm going to be honest with you, man. Aquas is an idiot. Bottom line. Like the dude is an idiot, man. But besides that, I'm not here to bash no other man. But besides that, dude always had my, like, ever since I was on Grind Time, dude always had something to say about me, like, negative. And then well, my point of it is, why talk about somebody? Or even if I talked about you first, at this point, I don't even really remember, but I think it was him. But if it was me, cool. Why entertain it if you're not willing to battle? That's what we do. There's been a lot of people that have said my name. If I got no interest in battling you, I'm not even going to make the fans think it's a chance that we're battling. I'm just going to ignore you. And then I'm not going to say nothing to you. This dude will go out his day to mention me, to talk about me, all of that, and then won't battle. And at this point, before I used to think, oh, maybe he may feel like, oh, DNA's name is not hot. At this point, I'm doing Aqua the favor to even talk to him. For him to even breathe the same air I'm breathing, I'm doing him a favor. So for him to say, DNA, I don't want to battle, he's scared. He's scared. Aquas is not who Aquas was 2 years ago. Aquas lost like 5 battles in a row. His kryptonite is white people. He's
so scared. Wait, you would still take Aquas? Like, listen.
Yeah, yes, I would still take Aquas only because I don't like Aquas, and there's so much stuff that I got to tell Aquas that I would battle. I just want to destroy him because he talks so much, and he's not good. Like, I'm not going to, like, that's one thing about me. Whether I'm battling you or not, I'm going to tell you if I think you're nice or not while we battling. And my sole purpose battling Aquas is because he runs his mouth. I think Aquas is horrible. He is horrible.
I see Aver get into it with Aquas as well. And he actually just called me. He's actually coming on the show right now.
I'm gonna be honest with you. You know how I do when I get on the show, man. I don't want nobody else on my interview, man. So Aquas, you can call in URL Battle Rap Arena next week and do your own. This is my show right now. I don't want to talk to you. I'm not giving him no notoriety. He can't have a conversation with me. You can write me through Twitter. You might not even know if I'm writing you back through Twitter. It might be somebody else that I got writing you. You cannot talk to me. We can't speak. Nothing, man.
Hold on. Are you DNA's tooth? Yes or no?
No, I am not. I don't know who that guy is, but he's funny. I'm not him, man. You know what's funny about it? He writes all the people that I want to battle or I got rivalries with in battles, and that's the funny thing. He talks to Aquas every day. That's the funny thing. So I'll be laughing watching it. But You know what I mean? On a serious note, though, man.
I'm kidding. I didn't say him. I said A-verb. A-verb is on the line. That's what I said. I didn't say awkward.
Oh, no. Me and A-verb ain't really go back and forth and say nothing since the last time. But still, this is my show, man. Tell A-verb to call next week, man. Rules don't change anybody, man. I'm sorry. Shout out to A-verb, man. I like him against X-Factor. But, I'm good.
You're horrible, man. Captain Marvel.
This is how I gotta do it, man. This is not, this what, like, y'all didn't book DNA and A-Verb, or DNA and Hawkins, y'all booked DNA. You know what I mean? A-Verb been on here more time than me. He gonna get a chance to say what he gotta say.
A-Verb did get too wild to see. I mean, would you want to take A-Verb if he beats Rex? I mean, you're pretty much just D for taking anybody, though, right? Pretty much.
A-Verb said he didn't want to battle me a lot of times. Shout out to A-Verb. He's a talented dude. Me and him will never battle. Shout out to him, though. Let him, he can do his thing, man. I like him. I will never battle him. Once you try to turn me down and act like I'm not worth it, cool. We don't got to battle. I don't want to battle him. He does his thing. I do my thing. We both exist in this world of battle rap. We can keep it moving.
Okay. Next caller.
Yeah, let's go to the next call. 414, you there?
Yo, what up, DNA?
Yo, what's good?
Hey, I just want to say, okay, you battle, like, almost everybody, man. Like, who next after you next?
I mean, whoever Smack make that call for, man, if it's right, you know what I mean, I'm with it, man. I mean, at this point, man, I might have to take one of these young dudes, man. Well, let me not even say young, because I'm young, but I mean young in the game. Like, one of these new dudes, man. I may have to go down, man.
I see you go against John Dunn. I think that'll be a good battle for you. I mean, for John.
I mean, John is my man, and it's a lot of stuff people might find out later on that we got in the works or whatever. So I probably would say not John, but any one of the other new dudes, definitely.
Hey, Smack, I mean, both of us had a few words for you.
I mean, listen, man, if Smack calls and it's right, I'll do it. I'm not like, listen, man, I'm not going to say no to nobody, man. If that call is right and it's what I want to hear on that line, man, let's do it. It's nothing else to call.
I want to see you and be Magic. I want to see a bar.
I was about to say that.
Huh?
I want to see you and be Magic. I want to see a bar fest.
I really want to see B-Magic is coming off of what, three losses? Two losses? What? Who's three losses? Young Cannon and Real Deal, right? Those are two losses. Wait, did you say that, Jesse? Oh, no. What about Young Cannon? Hold on, young Cannon didn't beat him?
Rosenberg. What about Rosenberg?
Listen, Jess. What I'm trying to say is that B-Magic last three battles, they've been debatable. He didn't clearly lose to nobody, honestly. I'm going to be honest. Yeah. I
was pretty convinced Real Deal beat him.
No, that could go either way. Real Deal was going off and so was B-Magic. It's a good battle. It's a classic battle at the end of the day. Huh?
I was asking Jesse, what about Rosenberg?
Nah, Rosenberg, he lost, so that was my fault. Rosenberg, he won. That was my fault. I mean, Rosenberg, hasn't won the battle. But, I mean, Young Cannon, he's coming off two losses, two big losses, Young Cannon and Real Deal. I feel like he lost both of those battles, to be honest.
Who gave you
just look at the crowd reaction, like, who got the line of the night, Real Deal got the line of the night.
Again, Jesse, again, you just said the dumbest shit I've heard in my life. We just spoke about the
Real Deal didn't get the line of the night?
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest, Jesse, man. I don't know what Molly you be taking, man. I don't know what you put in your drink, man. You gotta stop drinking it, man. Stop taking it, man. Listen, man, B-Magic, I'm not gonna tell you that B-Magic won all his battles, but he didn't lose either. It's debatable. It's what you like. You know what I mean? Like, B-Magic, he really ain't lose a battle. It's all debatable. MQP is debatable.
How do you say he came off of two big losses?
He lost to Young Cannon in Detroit, which was a big stage. And he lost to Real Deal when Real Deal was making off his debut.
But some people...
Real Deal? What are you talking about?
Yes. I'm going to be real. I'm going to be honest with you. A lot of people think he lost the Young Cannon, but it's still debatable. I'm going to be honest. But the real deal is 50-50. That's what I'm seeing. I see some people say real deal one. I feel like
real deal is 50-50 just off the fact that, like, URL fans just refuse to let real deal in.
Holy
That's
shit.
Why I feel like it's 50-50.
Are you fucking serious, Jesse? That is because, are you dating the real deal?
I mean, just look at some of those comments. They're like, oh, you know, like, well, half of those comments are racist comments.
Can you mute Jesse?
Am I wrong?
Can anybody just mute Jesse?
Wait, hold on. Am I wrong, though? Like, these URL fans just don't want to let, like, real deal in.
What are you talking about?
Half of the comments say, oh, what is this white boy trying to do in the URL stage and whatnot, blah, blah, blah. But if you listen to what, if you listen to that battle, Real Deal pretty much won, and he won in the place that night, which I think matters, which you guys don't agree with.
I'm gonna tell you how Jesse judges. Okay, ready, DNA? You ready?
What'd you say?
Okay. I'm gonna show you how Jesse judges. Ready? I went to the bathroom and I took a leak and the crowd goes crazy. Holy shit, did you hear that? And Jesse thinks people won. Okay. Doesn't matter what the person just said. All that matters is that the crowd went crazy. Which
crowd reaction me every day.
No, I'm just saying, like, what if crowd reaction doesn't matter at all, then why even have it then? But
Jeff, I'm gonna be honest. We all know this as battle rappers and battle rap fans. A battle looks one way when it's live and looks totally different on camera. And the same people that was cheering live just saying that shit is whack when it comes out on camera.
Yeah, I agree 100%. I mean, X Factor versus Clips was debatable on camera to me, but in person, like, you still can't take away just me being there, the feeling of me being there in person.
No, you can't take it away, but what I'm saying is that everything the crowd cheers for don't have to be hot. Like, my nigga, it's an effect. If we all in the room and all three of y'all on the phone is cheering for something, I might cheer for it just because I see y'all doing it. It might be whack. And then when I watch it later or when I think about it after, like, why did I just do that? Like, it wasn't hot. you can't go by the crowd. Like the crowd.
So then why does stage presence matter? Why does Powerful have a chance against Lux just off of stage presence?
If we're not being 100% honest.
Yeah, go ahead.
The crowd matters. What I'm saying is that you shouldn't judge the battle off the crowd. You should judge the battle off of what you're hearing. If you like it, then you think that person won. I don't judge. When I'm watching a battle live, I don't judge off what everybody else is doing. I judge what I'm listening to. Now, if I feel the same way that the crowd does, then, I mean, I guess we're agreeing on the same thing. But if I don't, then that's my opinion. Of course, big presence in the crowd matters live. For the battler, I'm talking about as the fan. There's been battles where you watched it and the dude that you probably wanted to win, that you probably was rooting for wasn't getting a reaction, and you still feel like you won. So that got nothing to do with the crowd. That's your opinion. As a battler, you got to worry about the crowd. As a fan, you just go with what you want, what you like. You like
Sometimes you can't worry about the crowd because they're pulling for an individual.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly. The crowd, put it like this, I'm going to be honest. Sometimes it's fair. Most of the time, the crowd picks who they want to win before they even get to the battle.
True. Exactly. I was there for the A-Verb versus X-Factor battle, and not taking anything away from X-Factor. I think X-Factor won. So he went crazy. When I was in the building, I was arguing with people because I was like, I think it was a close battle. Everybody in the building was like, you're crazy. X-Factor killed them. The battle drops, and people say Herb won or X-Factor won. You gotta drown out the crowd because they cheer on. So, Averb is the best villain alive. He's an amazing villain. And he embraces it. And if you go by the crowd, he won't win any battles. Let's be real. It's crazy. You cannot sit there and just listen to the crowd reaction because it doesn't mean anything.
I don't know. I mean, to me, like, a lot of what Calico does relies on the crowd. So, like, how can Calico win without a crowd, you know?
My nigga, if Calico does not rely on the crowd, people get swayed by the crowd.
How about one of the best lines in the Arsenal shit was, come on, Smack, I had to tell Uncle Trick Trick to chill, Smack. Like, that shit was hot, you know, the way it happened. That was, and where's the lyricism in that?
Can anybody give him a Percocet or something to shut him the fuck up?
All right, my bad. But, I mean, am I right or am I wrong?
Jesse, the line, Jesse, we're not talking about the fucking crowd. We're talking about the line. You said a line. Like, what are you talking about?
A line that had to do with the crowd. Like,
don't make
crowd
me get A-Verb on the show if I'm talking to you. Do not make me call A-Verb to talk to you.
I feel the way I feel. Like, I mean, you guys feel the way you feel. I feel like Big Magic lost to Young Cannon in Real Deal.
No, I'm saying if you feel that way, we don't disagree with your opinion, but you're just saying that he clearly lost. It's debatable.
Yeah, it is. And you
that's all I'm saying.
The reason with DNA, like, the reason you sound crazy is because you said that he got the biggest reaction of the night. In other words, you're basing it on the crowd going for noodles as opposed to what was said.
That's your opinion.
And that's why you sound stupid. Yeah. Like, that's why you sound retarded.
Let's go to that call.
I am laughing.
You there?
Yeah, what's up, everybody? Can you hear me?
Yeah, we hear you.
What's up, brother? Hey, first off, I like to say, man, I think DNA is a legend. He definitely belongs on the stage, man. I feel like it's kind of like the situation with Mook, man, where you started off as a young gang, grind time, we kind of see you go blossom, and you get better and better. You're one of the best in the world at this point, in my opinion.
Good listen, yo. I appreciate it, man.
No doubt. But I got two questions. Who do you got next up in the King of the Dot? And I'd actually like to see you against Real Deal. And would you ever battle Hollow the Don?
If everything was set up right, I'd battle Real Deal. But nah, only reason why I would never battle Hollow besides off GT and being my man is two. Me and him is like on the underground scene beyond battling. We like the only two dudes doing it for Queens. So, you know what I mean? We both agreed at the beginning of this shit, and even more so as our names got popular, like we would never battle. Because, you know what I mean, we the ones holding it down for Queens. It's only me and Hollow. I mean, if you really look in the terms of battle shit, you know what I mean? And shout out to, and this ain't off of talent, I'm talking about status-wise, you know what I mean? Shout out to Team Moneybags, shout out to Amzilla, it's a lot of other niggas that be holding down Queens to the fullest, but popularity-wise, it's me and Hollow, so, you know what I mean? We agreed that would never go at it. But, you know what I mean? Yeah, I would battle Real Deal if everything was right. I mean, like, yo, this is my whole thing. We all battle. Nobody got a deal. Nobody got $1 million. So I'm not gonna say I won't battle nobody. That's how I feel like everybody should feel. If the opportunity arises and it's correct, why wouldn't you battle somebody that's in the same field as you? Like, when I mean that, I mean in URL or in King of the Dot or in whatever league you battle for. Yeah. Man, it's just like NBA, man.
I feel like you and me, Real Deal would be a classic, definitely.
Yeah, I agree. I think so, too, man. I think this battle shit got to get formatted like the NBA, man. Whether the Heat, the Miami Heat is the best team on any given night, they got to play the Wizards, too. And I'm not saying that anybody's on a level of the Wizards status. I'm just saying if somebody feels like, oh, this dude is below him, in the NBA, in professional basketball, even in the NFL, in baseball, you face everybody. That's how I feel it should be in battle rap. Like, nobody should be able to run from nobody. That's how you really find out who's nice. Because you're going to battle with all types of people and everybody.
Definitely. All right, man. That's all I had to ask. I respect the fact that you're not going to battle Hollow. I think that's some loyal shit, man. That's real shit. But, yeah.
No, I mean,
thanks
yeah,
for your time.
I mean,
appreciate it.
Good looking, yo. No doubt. Good looking for calling.
Thanks for the call. Let's go to 315, you there?
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's good? Yo, what up, DNA?
Yo, what's good?
Yo, you probably, like, probably, like, I can't even see that you lost any of your battles. You know what I mean? Like, Big T is debatable, but to me, like, I think you won all your battles, so I can't really see that nobody is above you. Like, you should have been able to battle Mook. And I really think that Mook's probably going to run from you because he don't want you to lose to a young kid that's, like, out here just like he was. But anyway, but Norbs, I want to talk to you, Norbs, because I was on Twitter today, and I heard you, or not heard you, but I saw you beefing with so-and-so. You know, you got to get off that, man. Like, you above that, man. Like, you're supposed to be a partner in a big corporation, and, like, fuck what other niggas talking about. Like, you're supposed to be above that type of shit. Like, I didn't even know about since you mentioned
I don't even know who that is.
Who's that?
I don't know who
you
mentioned
about?
It and blew out one of your shows. Like, it was like, I don't know, a while ago. And you got mad. Then I started checking them off. And I was just like,
who is
damn,
this nigga?
Like, I had no idea who he was before.
Man, I
should be above that,
bro.
Though. You know what I mean? Like,
I feel what you're saying, my nigga, but it's like...
Niggas gonna hate like, all the time, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I feel you, but when people go on rant, it's like people start believing lies. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just crazy. You sit there and you're like, damn. If I, like, my job, and all our jobs, basically everybody, I'm the most reachable person. You know what I'm saying? And I gotta tell people if they're not good enough. And that's a tough job, and people understand that. And
yeah.
DNA knows that shit. Yeah, I thought DNA was definitely good enough when I brought DNA in. And for every DNA, there's 100 average battlers that I have to tell they're not good enough to be in the best place. And some people can't handle it. They can't handle it. And when I have to tell people that, then they try to get malicious or they try to lie on you and try to use Twitter or other social networks to try to destroy your character. You know what I'm saying? And say you have favorites or you have this. But nigga, like, everybody that's been brought to the URL, I had a
hand
in
it. I was just thinking that. Listen, like, I watch this shit for real. Like, I watch this shit, all this shit. Everybody on URL. You have co-signed everybody who's on there. Basically. I don't even know a person that you haven't co-signed, to be honest. So, like,
and
that's what I'm saying. Like, this niggas gonna hate.
No, I feel it. It's just get to the point where it's like, that's one of the reasons I don't like to set up battles with the bigger dudes. Because it's egos, my nigga. Like, it's crazy. Like, it's easy to set up those battles. It's harder to find the next talent. It's harder to find the next DNA, the next John McDonald. You know what I mean? But like I said, with that comes a lot of responsibility because you've got to tell people they're not good enough and people can't handle it. You understand? I mean, DNA will call me and tell me, yo, I'll check this dude out. I'm gonna check him out. If he's dope, I'm gonna say he's dope. It is what it is. I've lost a lot of friends due to the fact that I have to be real with them. See what I'm saying? Like, nah, you're not good enough to do this, my nigga. So, it is what it is. And some people can't handle that. And if you tell a person they're not good, it's not that they're not good, it's that I'm a hater. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And that bothers me about the situation. But I definitely appreciate, you know, the feedback. I definitely feel you, son.
Yeah, no doubt.
Thanks for the call. Let's go to 347, you dead?
No, good. Yeah, hear me?
Yeah, we
here. Yeah, what's up? Yo, DNA was good, son.
Yo, it was good.
Alright, to be honest, I think, you lost a young girl or whatever. And besides that, like, since that battle, I think, like, you've been doing your shit or whatever. And I tweeted that, like, the other day, like, you had the best battle I ever saw. Well, Disaster or whatever. I want to know, like, how did you, like, prepare for that shit? Because that shit was crazy.
I mean, what's crazy about it is, out of all my battles, like, I can say that's the one that I least prepared for. I freestyled a lot of my material in there. You know what I mean? That's the crazy thing about it. I mean, I was just in a zone because, you know, I knew that he freestyled a lot, so I know that I'd have to bring out my freestyle game for that battle, and we had a rivalry. He was talking a lot before the battle, so I just wanted to go out there and do my best, and, you know, I mean, that's probably one of the best times I ever freestyled on camera in a battle because of that, plus what I had prepared before, but a lot of my preparation was like 2 or 3 days before the battle, and the rest was just right then and there.
Yeah, that shit was crazy. Like, that was, like, one of the best battles I saw. Like, I was like, damn. Like, then I showed my friend that shit. He was like, that's my favorite rapper, you know. I was like, yeah, that nigga nice or whatever. I was like, that shit was crazy, though. Good shit, though, man. Good luck on the selling Mariner shit, man. Cause
good luck, y'all. I appreciate it, man.
You're up there now, man. You just gotta stay up there.
All right.
Good luck, man. I'm trying, man. We got a lot of these new dudes, man. That's on our heels, but I'm trying, man. It's crazy.
7-8, you there?
Yeah. What up, Psycho? Jesse Rakin Norks. DNA was popping.
Yeah, it was good.
Nothing, chilling. Hey, yeah, DNA. Yeah, I've been following you for a while, and I feel you definitely top tier. Like you say, you main event in every, you know what I'm saying, other league. You've been in every league as the main event, so you can't overlook that. Only a blind man can't see that. And I wanted to say, since, you know what I'm saying, you don't know really what it's going to be with the top tier. Like, I heard you said you won't mind taking out the young dude, because I want to see a bar fest like with you or Chilla or you and JC. What do you think about those matchups?
I mean, yeah, man, like I said, yo, Smack, that's something, I mean, Smack and them, you know, entertained or whatever, and they want to see it, I'm with it. I mean, it's, because to me, at the same time, some people may feel like I'm giving them a shot, but they already know in their own right. They might not be as known as I am, but they know him. So it's not really a shot, you know what I mean? It's just, we battling. You know, I mean, if they talented and I'm talented, it ain't no reason why it can't happen if everything is right. The business, the timing, the events, all of that. So, yeah, I'll see what's up, man.
Well, what you think about the battle of the both of the most underrated, you versus Tay Rock? That'd be off the chain.
Yeah, that'd be a hot battle, too. I mean, me personally, I feel like Tay Rock is top tier, so I don't. I mean, I don't see no reason why we couldn't battle either.
That's what's up. That's all I had to say. Shout out to the show, y'all. Keep doing y'all thing.
All right.
Good luck, man.
Thanks a lot. 314, you there?
Yeah, hello?
Yeah, we are.
First of all, I just want to say, DNA, I ain't necessarily like a big fan of yours, but I do respect your style. You do, you know, you got some bars and shit. You go with hot shit every battle I've seen, so respect to you on that one. I just want to say, I think that was like last week on Twitter, like you and Conceited had kind of went back and forth a little bit, and you were saying that you would battle him, you know, at Summer Madness 2, like after your E-Ness battle. Like, what, I guess my question is, like, what kind of brought that about?
Now, to be honest, me and Khan, we was possibly joking, then it got serious a little bit, but, you know what I mean, then we talked and shit, so it ain't really gonna go down. I ain't even going, I mean, it was never that serious, but it was one point, because, you know what I mean, he ain't like something I did, I ain't like something he did, so we were saying, like, yo, it's whatever, but I don't think that battle's going to go down. I mean, and not to take away that Khan is not my man, because Conceited, I mean, I talk to him almost every other day, so that's my man. But because so many people would want to see it, I would do it. Because a lot of people want it. I mean, Conceited, punchline, not punchline. You know what I mean? It's a hot battle. It sounds hot on paper, so I would do it. But, you know what I mean? I wouldn't pursue it. I wouldn't do a blog. I wouldn't diss him or nothing. If he agreed to it one day, I would do it. And, you know what I mean, we just go all bars to see who's better. But if not, I mean, I understand too, because, you know what I mean, some people can't get their mind state to battle people they're cool with like that. So,
you know what's funny about that too? Like, when you battle Ron, you know, Conceited was there, and I think he said, like, a couple things to you, and, like, there was mad comments saying that Conceited goes for it. for DNA that battle, Conceited with Ghost Riding for DNA that battle. Like, I mean, does shit like that get under your skin too? Like, I think Rome might have been your best performance on camera at that time, right? More or less. And
yeah,
then, like, as soon as you did have it, like, all those YouTube comments were saying, oh, Conceited Ghost Riding for him. I mean, does that shit get on your nerves?
I mean, no, because somebody's always going to have something to say. Like, if it wasn't Conceited Ghost Riff for me, it would be if DNA didn't pull out the bomb, we wouldn't have won. Or DNA was in New York. Like sometimes you just can't listen because somebody's always going to find something. The funny part about that is that, you know, I mean, me and Tom being cool, Khan knew my rhymes before the battle. So after the people went crazy once I said, if you ain't going to replace it, don't say shit, I was about to just go into the part about extra kids. I bring text to ribs. I ask your mom, yes, I did. Your girl, yes, she is. Whatever that part, right? But Khan told me, like, yo, don't. He whispered to me when the crowd was going crazy, yo, don't forget about the Penn State run. And that's when I looked at him, like, oh, yeah. And then that's why I went into the line about, and plus all your men fake. It's ironic a dude that can't write and rolls into Penn State. Because I was about to forget a ball because the crowd was going crazy. That's what happened. But, you, of course, people, who Khan is whispering. Like Khan is whispering DNA to rhymes he wrote for me. It just sounds so funny because it's like, you seen me rhyme before I even was cool with Khan, and I was nice. Like, somebody having the best battle or best performance don't mean they didn't have lyrics that was better in another battle. It just means everything was put together in that battle. The lyrics, the performance, the delivery, the presence, all of that. So you heard me say crazy rhymes before. So how could you say Khan won for me? It's like before I knew Charlie Clips, I had the battle with Ron. I had the battle with like five other dudes. Then I get with him and they like, oh, Charlie Clips writes for you. And then it's like, so who's writing for me before I knew Clips? Who's writing for me before I knew Conceited? it makes no sense. But that's what happens, man. If it ain't that, it's something. It's always something. They got something to say about everybody.
Let's go to 323, you there?
Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, what's good?
You hear me?
Yeah.
Yo, I got a question and a comment. Yo, D. Hands down, my dude, you know what I'm saying? You're definitely doing your thing, man. You know what I'm saying? The haters don't hate. And that just shows you that you're doing the right motherfucking thing, man. You know what I'm saying? I fucks with you. I like your battles. I watch all your battles. Definitely keep doing your thing. You know what I'm saying? I hope you kill Ness at Summer Madness, too.
Good looking, yo. I appreciate it, man.
Hey, and Norris, you there?
Norris?
Yo, we lost Norris? Is Norris there?
Yeah, I think we lost him for a second, but you
No,
you're right there.
No, I'm here,
what's up?
Hey, Norris, I gotta agree with you, what you said the last time, the last show when Enes was supposed to be on, man. Jesse's a fucking retard, bro. I don't know what kind of battles you be watching, bro. Oh, how the fuck you judging them and shit, man? But you sound like an amateur judging these battles off fucking, you know what I'm saying, crowd reactions and all that shit, you know what I'm saying? Because, like I said, you know what I'm saying, sometimes the crowd say some shit. I mean, the battle rappers say some shit.
You know what it is? I'll be the only one to admit it, but I mean, mad people do it, because if a majority of the people didn't do it, then we wouldn't have, like, if a majority of the people zoned out and thought on their own, I'm the only person that says that it does play a factor, but everybody else wants to say, nah, I'm above that. But then we wouldn't have the reactions we do.
So you do admit you're a bad judge. I totally agree.
I think that plays a factor in it. I think if you could get, I mean, why do we call this, why do we call stage presence an advantage if it's not going to be an advantage? Stage presence controlling the crowd, it should be a factor. Head Ice is nice because he knows how to work the crowd.
Yes,
you know what, Jesse?
Again, you can't judge off a crowd reaction.
You know what?
I'm going to tell y'all one thing
that I learned off of Jesse's predictions. That I can be a fucking rich man if I bet on the opposite motherfucker that he, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm going to do from now on. You said that Ness was going to kill DNA. I think you said the same shit about Tech. I remember you said that shit about Tech. Oh, yeah, Tech goes. So, you know, from now on, I need a little bit of extra cash. Anybody out there that want to bet me, I'm going against whoever the fuck chest, you're not going for it.
I mean, that's how I feel. I just
But, I mean, that's it for me, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to take too much of the time. A lot of these motherfuckers are asking the same fucking question. But, definitely, y'all do y'all thing. Hey, Nobs, Jesse, besides the fact that, you know, you're a little off, I fucked with you, Psycho, DNA, keep doing your motherfucking thing, man. I am Dinero Sucio, yo, man. Fuck with y'all, man.
Yo, good looking, man. I appreciate it, man. Good looking for calling in, man. Yo,
I bet.
Yeah. One. Yo, before y'all go to another call, man, I wanted to say something real quick because I got to go back in the studio in a second. Finish this mixtape that I'm about to put out tomorrow. So I just want to tell everybody that's listening, that's watching on the show, I think around 5 p.m. tomorrow, make sure you go download this mixtape that I'm dropping with DJ Logical. He's from Ohio. It's like 7 to 10 joints, real quick, freestyles, because I've been supposed to put out my underrated, underpaid mixtape. It's in the works, so to hold y'all over until that comes out. I got a mixtape called GTFOH. It's dropping tomorrow, 7 to 10 tracks, all freestyles, all industry beats, livemixtapes.com. It'll be on URL. Make sure y'all go download that.
What's up? One more question before you leave, Andy?
Yeah.
Go ahead,
Tyler. Let me see, 716, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. What's poppin', y'all?
What's good?
What's good? It's Big Mark from Twitter. What's poppin', DNA?
Yo, what's good?
I told you I was gonna call in a quick question. Remember we was chopping it up before on Twitter about you and Clips doing a little sparring session. I just wanted to know, is that still in the works? Y'all still gonna do that?
Me and Clips be talking about it, man, but that's the funny thing. So when you cool with somebody like that, it's hard to even be serious battling. Like people don't know, even though it's a show, even though it's entertainment, like, you have to have some type of anger towards the person to even front, like, yo, for these 9 minutes, I hate him. And I just see, like, even if it was on URL, King of the Dot, a cypher anywhere, I'd just be laughing the whole time Clips is rhyming. And I wouldn't even be able to rhyme because it would just be funny to me. So probably not unless one day we just, sometimes we'd be arguing and we'd be getting tight. But I don't think we would record it though. But yeah, nah.
Gosh,
my man, like, for real, that's like a brother. So nah, I would never do that.
Alright, I can respect that. Another thing is with the next battle, with your approach to this battle, what do you think his strengths are that's going to give you a problem that you would, if you want to elaborate on that, that you think that he brings to the table that you're going to have to counter?
I mean, you know, Ness got flow and Ness is aggressive, so, you know, I mean, that's nothing that I've never dealt with before, but that's something that if he's on his A game with it, I'm going to have to counter it. And my approach, man, is the unpredictable, man. You don't know what's going to happen. A lot of people got their approach on what I'm going to do, so we're going to see, man, but that's one thing I can say. Most of the time, I'm able to come up with something that nobody expected, so we're going to see.
That's what I'm expecting. I do expect it to be a classic. I was one of the candidates saying that, yo, no tooth, none of that, no tooth, no cheesecake, just off the strength that I know y'all come way more creative than that. I know y'all said it earlier in the show, but I couldn't talk at that moment. But, I do think it's going to be a classic. I don't want you to sleep on him because I know I see a lot of people on Twitter is zeezing on him, just thinking he washed or whatever the case may be. I don't want you to do that because I think that, I don't know what happened with the tech battle. You just didn't seem yourself in that battle. It just was a little weird to me. You normally come a lot harder with the performance. I don't know if you had something going on, whatever that is, but I just want to see a better performance just go around because I know you could do a lot better. That's just my personal, you know what I'm saying, my personal opinion on that. I still gave you the W. I don't know what the hell Tech was doing, but I still gave you the W in that one. But I am looking forward to you and Ness battle.
Yeah, nah, definitely, man. Nah, I'm definitely not sleeping on him, man. I know what time it is, you know what I mean? I know the stage. I know the run that I've been on besides the Tech battle, but the disaster, the error, you know what I mean? So, the anticipation is there. And then a lot of people, you know what I mean? Me and X Factor, last show on Summer Madness, it was debatable.
Some people think he won. Some people think I won. But, you know, I mean, a lot of people said I had one of the craziest rounds, the first round that I had back from coming back. So I'm really trying to outdo myself this year and make a better round than that, and then a better round in 2 and 3. But, yeah, man, I definitely know, man. I'm not, I will never sleep on him. I keep telling people this. I'm not saying this because I don't want to sound rude. If I felt like he was going to be whack, I'll say he's trash. He's going to be whack. I really think he's going to come with it and step up because, like I said, this is the moment where he has to. I mean, not even because he's battling me, because of the stage, because of how many people's counting him out. No matter who he went against, he has to step up. I believe he will.
All right, that's what's up. All right, shout out Norv, Psycho, Jesse, and my brother Peasy. You know what I'm saying? Good looking, y'all. All
right. All right.
Thanks
for the call. All
right, G, thanks for joining us, man. Anything else you want to say before you let us go?
Yo, man, shout out to URL Battle Rap Arena. Shout out to all of y'all for having me on here again, man. This is my third time. Follow me on Twitter at DNA_GTFOH, Facebook/DNA_GTFOH. Bookings and features, book DNA now at gmail.com. And make sure, man, whether you might not like it, you know what I mean? Well, I think you're going to like it, but whether or not, man, show the support. You know what I mean? We do this for y'all when we do the battles. We show support to y'all. So show support back tomorrow, 5 p.m. or around that time. Big time. Download that new mixtape, 7 to 10 Freestyles, GTFOH, hosted by DJ Logical at livemixtape.com. You know what I mean? That's all for now, man. And if you don't got your tickets, get your tickets now, man. Summer Madness 2, DNA vs. EMS, and all the other crazy battles that I know is on there. So you got to be in the building for that.
Yeah, that's
it, man.
All right, you are
well. Get him the fuck out of here. What's up, Nuff?
Get him the fuck out of here.
All right. URL's Battle Rap Arena. Check us out tomorrow night, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thanks again, DNA, for coming on. We out.
Smack!
Smack!
Steppin' with my hammer dance. If I really had one on, you wouldn't stand her up. I'm two-steppin' with my hammer dance. If I really had one on, you wouldn't stand her up. What can I say? I'm a people's person. The fans love me, love me. And my words touch the kids like Sandusky. If you beefin' at any time and your man touch me, let's throw the hands. I bet you stand Van Gundy. If I swing, you'll get decked so hard. But not me, I'm on cue like Fredro Starr. I done spit around the world, so respect those bars. I swear all you rappers like Metro cars. See, I can hang for 250. Then you get so scared and put your transfers out, cause it's no fair. See, I'm the best, and lyrically I'm Einstein. Nigga, this is grind time, I ain't going nowhere. I mean, I really don't talk to niggas. I beat up ghetto and even corporate niggas. And if we fightin', then I'm off the niggas. Doc said I got high blood pressure from a...
Smack!
some bitch on a green line with a mean nine and won't even let three go. See that bitch, I'll approach her with that poker, poke her and her amigos and watch blood spray in that subway. Now that's a cold cut tree. I mask up like Rip, ready to pull shit. Now from my spine go ding, he'll do a full flip. Let him buy a Rolls Royce. I run up with a full clip, send one through the rolls and tear ACL. Now that's some bullshit.
Niggas, y'all niggas, that's that shit I don't like. Yo shit, make believe, rapping about my own life. That's Rand, nigga. Woo! Ric Flair, nigga. Woo! The power's in my hair, nigga. Woo! I get to beat the chair, nigga. So loud. Tribeca, three hoes, trifecta. Dope money, coke money, shoe blow. My watch better, my pen's better. You don't write, trendsetter. You clone like, pay homage or K's vomit. Ungrateful niggas I don't like. Rah!
A fuck, nigga, that's that shit I don't like.
Bang, bang.
A snitch, nigga, that's that shit I don't like.
Bang, bang.
A bitch, nigga, that's that shit I don't like.
Bang, bang.
A sneak, nigga, that's that shit I don't like.
Chicago, smile in my face is what I don't like. They steal your hoes.
Bitch, I bet you I got that third today.